Okay, so we're going to start with a little video first. We're going to start with two videos because we're going to, and then we'll go to the workbook. All right, so I'm going to show you two videos.
Workbook.
Oh, we're going to start with our workbook. Okay.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Hello, Q.
Textbook.
Yes, this is the activity book. Right there. All right. But first thing we're going to do is watch two quick little videos. One is on parts of a tree, and the other are parts of a plant. So let's have a look at the parts of the plant first. They're pretty close. They're pretty close. Parts of a plant. So let's look at that one first. They're almost the same, except for some words.
We will learn about the parts of a plant. A plant has many different parts, and each part has a set of works to do to keep the plant healthy. Plants provide us with food materials, medicines, wood, and they also convert carbon monoxide into life-giving oxygen. Amazing! The two important main parts of the plant are the root and the shoot. Roots originate from the lower portion of a plant inside the ground. Roots absorb moisture and nutrients, anchor the plant in the soil, support the stem, and store food. Such as potatoes and carrots. Shoots is the part of plant that we can see above the ground level. The undeveloped shoot is called the bud. The shoot has different parts called the stem, leaves, flowers, and fruits. Let's learn about each part one by one. The stem. It is the stalk of the plant. It helps the plant to stand upright. It is generally green when young and later often becomes dark brown. The stem carries water and minerals from the roots to leaves and carries food prepared by the leaves to the different parts of the plant. The branches. Branches are parts that grow from the stem. The leaves. Leaves grow on the stem and branches. They're usually green due to the presence of chlorophyll that helps them to prepare their own food. Interesting. Leaves also make the oxygen in the air that we breathe. Leaves have small openings called stomata, through which plants take in and give out air. The flowers. Flowers generally are the showiest, beautiful part of a plant. Their fragrance and beauty attract pollinators, like birds and insects, that play an important role in the reproductive process. Isn't it cool? The fruits. By the process of pollination, many flowers grow into yummy fruits which we eat. So yum, ha! The seed. The fruits contain seeds. Some fruits have one seed, some have two, and some fruits can have many seeds that grow into new plants. Here is the diagram for your review. Look carefully. This is root, the stem, branch, leaf, flower, and fruit. And these are seeds. Now you know a lot about parts of a plant. Please drop a like, leave a comment, share the videos, and don't forget to subscribe. Our app, Learning Junction, is available on Play Store. Bye-bye.
Okay, those are parts of a plant. Now I'm going to show you parts of the tree, and it's almost the same thing. Look for the words that they're describing things. What you got there, and guy, what are you doing? All right, so let's see the parts of a tree. It's almost the same. No, this is the video first, and then we'll go to the page, okay? So let's look at the two videos first. Parts of a tree, there it is. And then we'll go to the page.
Today you will be learning about parts of tree. So let's start.
A tree has five parts. A tree has
parts. I don't hear.
Leaves, fruits, roots, branch, trunk. Repeat with me. Leaves, fruits, trunk, branch, roots, and trunk. Let's revise. Leaves, L-E-A-V-E-S, leaves. Branch, B-R-A-N-C-H, branch. Roots, R-O-O-T-S, roots. Trunk, T-R-U-N-K, trunk. Trunk. Fruits, F-R-U-I-T-S, fruits. Fruits. It's activity time, so are you ready? Yes, you will match the picture with correct words. Here you can see words and there are
teacher, I am the toilet.
Roots, branch, trunk, fruits, leaves. Let's do it again. Roots, branch, trunk, fruits, leaves. Good job. Kids, can you identify the parts of tree? Can you tell me that what part of tree is this? This is trunk. What part of the tree is this? Roots. What part of the tree is this? Leaves. What part of the tree is this? Fruits. What part of the tree is this? Branch. Student, now it's your turn.
Okay, whoops. There we go. Okay, so that was parts of a plant and parts of a tree. So let me show you this then, and we'll just review that. All right, so here we go. That was the parts of a tree.
What page?
Hold on, not a page yet. We're going to a page in 1 minute. Have a look first. That was the parts of a plant. You put them together. What do you notice? What are these called on both? What's that? And what's that? What are these? Right here. What's that called? Is that a leaf, fruit, trunk, branch, or roots? What do you think? So have a look at those two pictures. What am I pointing to at the bottom? What are they? They are roots. They are meant to be right. Awesome. They are called the same thing, root and root. What about this part of the tree?
Stem.
If you notice on a plant, it's a stem. On a tree, it's a?
Trunk.
Yeah, good. What about this part that goes out here?
Fruit.
What's this word here?
Branch.
This is the branch and look on the fruit. And on a plant.
Fruit and leaf.
You're well done. Hold on. Slow down. The roots, to the stem to the branch. The roots to the trunk to the branch. almost the same names. What do we have here?
Fruit.
What do we have here?
Leaf.
Not yet. What's the red one?
Fruit.
Yeah. The fruit called fruit. And what about this?
Leaf.
And what about this?
Leaf.
Yeah. The only difference is flowers. And we have a different name. Okay?
Teacher, apple.
Yes, I think these are apples. And these look
and
like...
Tomato.
Okay?
I think it's apple.
All right, but the names are almost the same. We have roots. We have leaves on both. We have fruit on both. We have branches on both. The only difference is the trunk and the stem. All right? So everything else is kind of the same. So let's go to our activity book.
Yes, what page?
Yes, what page? 33. All right, 33, the activity book.
Finish!
Finish!
Hold on.
Finish!
Did you guys label that already?
Finish.
All right.
Teacher, I am finished.
You're finished.
I am finished.
I am not finished.
All right. Let's go back to our page. Hold on. Slow down. All right. It's
finished.
33. Let me call it up. Page 33. Some of you are finished. Hold on. Some are finished. Some are not. All right. Wrong one. Sorry. We wanted the activity book. My mistake. There we go. Let's get the activity book. I called up the wrong one. Come on. There we go. All right. Let's label our tree and draw it in. Okay? So some of you are finished. Great. If you're not, we're going to add to this too. So we need to draw our trunk. That's not a very good trunk. So let's draw in our trunk. This is a tree trunk. And it always gets bigger at the bottom. All right. So that is our tree trunk. All right, the next thing we need in there is we need our roots, and they're just squiggly lines that go way into the soil. Okay. They bring water and nutrients, which is another word for food, to the tree. All right. So let's label those two. The one down here again is called what?
Roots.
They are roots, right? And this part is the
trunk.
It's a trunk on a tree.
Trunk.
It's a trunk.
Trunk.
That one's called a trunk. Trunk.
It's not truck. It's trunk.
It's trunk. I put truck. All right. So let's label something there.
Teacher,
yeah.
I'm writing the stem.
Okay. Well, it's a stem on a plant and a trunk on a tree. So they're different words, okay? So call this one a trunk. Let's move this over. Let me move this over here. I'll put it right in the middle. So on a tree, we call it a trunk. Where does it? Okay. I'll put that right there. That's a trunk. All right, so that's what we call it on a tree, and this is called a stem.
Teacher.
Yeah?
Finish page 34 and 35.
Well, don't go ahead.
35 and 34. Yes, finish too.
Well, that's, we're going to do something special with that. So, all right, hold on. Now, what are these green things called?
And 35.
What are these green things called?
34.
What are the green parts of a tree called up here?
Leaves.
And what are these brown parts called right here that's part of the tree? Remember the name of that one? Branch.
Branch.
A branch. Okay, the same as this. Oh, yeah, yeah. Branch. This is also called a branch.
Branch.
After the word branch and do that, okay? This part is the branch. And that part is the branch. All right. So put a little arrow up there. And up a little circle around it. There we go. All right. There's probably fruit on here, but we can't see it. So we got the roots, the trunk, the leaf, and the branch. The roots, the stem, the leaves, and the branch, and fruit. So it's almost the same. The only difference is the name of this. That's a stem. That's a trunk. Okay? So I'll leave that for a sec. Make sure you label that.
Trunk.
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 Trunk. Trunk. Trunk. Trunk. Trunk. Trunk.
Trunk. Trunk. Trunk. Trunk.
Trunk. Trunk.
Trunk. Trunk.
Trunk. Trunk. Trunk. Trunk.
Trunk. All right. So there's our two plants and a tree. Hold on. Let me turn that down. It's too loud.
Teacher, Chubby the dinosaur.
Ah! Dinosaur. Alright, are we finished with that?
Good.
Excellent. Okay, so leave that for now. We're going to go back to our book. All right, we'll go back to our book. I'm going to stop presenting this.
Teacher.
Did everybody write this down?
Teacher.
Yep.
I'm going to finish page 34, 35. I don't find leaves.
It's okay. I will show you pictures of leaves and we'll do that, okay? We're not going to do that page yet. We're going to go right back to the textbook. All right. We're going to go to the textbook. All right, so everybody label. Make sure you label all this. The only additions were branch, leaves, trunk, and roots. Oh. Sniffly nose. Sniffly nose. Hello, hello. Can you clap your hands?
No.
Hello, hello. Can you stamp your feet? Stamp. Can you stretch up high? Can you turn around? Are we ready? Can we move on?
Yeah.
Everybody finished?
Finished.
Oh, good. All right. So let's go to our textbook.
Textbook
on page
44. I am finished.
Have you finished? Well, we're going to look at each one of the cans.
44.
Yes. Note, and we're going to make sure they're all okay. 44.
Yay!
4, 4.
4, 4.
Okay. Now let's just label this one, okay? The talks about what each part do. So here we got the roots. What does the roots do? The roots help to, what's that word?
The roots help to drink water.
It does, down here, yes. It doesn't say that, but you're right. The roots help to drink water. Let's add that one. It's not even there. Roots help it to drink water. You're right. It brings
water.
Drink.
It drums. Go to leaf.
Yes. Roots help it to drink water. So it comes up from down here and
roots help to drink water, go to leaf.
Yep. Drink water.
Go to leaf.
It goes to leaves. You're right. Okay. Now this part again, let's make sure we're talking about the roots, but let's make sure, what is this part called again? What's this part called?
Stem.
So let's label that one, make sure we know. Keep
stem.
Using the words.
Stem.
Now this one, of course, is easy. What is this called?
Leaf.
What's the word some of you have forgotten probably? What is this part called? What's this part right here called? Do you remember?
Branch.
Branch. It is a branch. Nice one. Good. Same
branch.
As a tree. Same as on a tree. It's called a branch. Good one. All right. Nicely labeled. What else do roots do? They bring up water. What else is important that roots do? Read it here. The roots.
Help bring water.
It does bring water.
Up to bite.
It does.
Up to leaf.
To the leaves and the fruit and the
go to leaf. Go to
what does it say here? The root
to the
help to hold the plant in the ground. Look at this. Look what the roots are doing.
Right. Drink water, go to the leaf, go to the fruit, go to the
yep.
Leaf, go to the flower and
that's perfect. Fruit. Now the roots also down here help to keep the plant in the soil. Look at all this. If they didn't have any roots, they would just fall over. It would just be there. Hey, it's not, oh, and it would fall over in the wind. So they help keep the plants in the ground. Same thing.
Yes.
With trees. All right. So those are the roots for really two things. All right. Number one, hold it in the ground, and number two, to bring food. All right,
yes.
Food and water and nutrients, that's important. All right.
To drink water, go to leaf.
Does, flows all to the leaves. Now, we'll do one more page in this book, and then we'll stop and go back to the other one. So here we've got the roots. Next, they're going to talk about a stem. So let's turn the page. Okay. I think we already did 20. Next, we did 23.
Maven.
All right.
That is maven.
Now, this almost looks like a tree to me, but they say it's a plant. So it is called a stem.
What page?
This is on the next page. Page
47.
But we're not going to do this page. We're just going to do this one. So what is the stem for?
Stem for
Why do trees and plants have this thing?
I don't know.
What comes up through it to all the plants, all to the leaves?
Water. Go through the leaf.
That's what it is. It brings, the stem is there to bring water up to the leaves and fruits and the flower. So that's what our stem does. It brings water.
So that's what it does. Sun helps to bring water too.
Yes, it does. Sun helps give it food. Because they take the sun and they convert that to food, which is pretty amazing. Bring waters to the plant.
Teacher.
Okay.
The leaf is help make
What's the leaf help make?
Help make the eating the
I know what you're saying, Nut. You know what the leaves do? Why do the leaves turn to the sun? Why do the leaves want sun?
Color green.
It is green because they take the sun. So
make the food.
So if I take a light and we'll call the light the sun, here we go. That's the sun. All right, there's my light. It's the sun. All right, the sun makes the leaves, gives the leaves food. The plant changes the sun into food, which is pretty amazing. There we go. All right, so everybody make sure on this page.
Leaf is make the food.
Yes. That's what the sun does. Plants are amazing. They don't eat like we eat. They don't have a mouth where they eat an apple or a French fry.
They eat the iPad.
They eat the iPad. No, they don't. Pants won't. I don't think anybody would eat an iPad. All right. So everybody put in this brings water to the plant. All right.
Water to the plant.
All right. And then we're going to do a couple of leaf drawings that are at the school. Oops. Remember, I took pictures at the school. How are we doing? Everybody finished?
Yeah,
excellent. All right. You okay? I'm going to stop. All right. There we go. Bye bye. Oh no, teacher, I'm not finished. All right. So now go back to our. That's a workbook. Yeah. Back to our activity book.
Activity book.
Page 34.
34. Okay, 34. I'm not finished. 34.
Okay.
Finish.
All right, so let's look at page 34.
I am finished.
Are you finished? Good. Oh,
I'm finished. Okay.
We'll go back to that. Okay. Okay. Calm down. But you want me to go back to that for a minute?
I'm not finished.
Okay. So let me go back. Let me go back. You guys turn to that page. Let me get this one finished so everybody has it finished. Hello, hello. There we go. So this is what you need to write in. Brings water to the plant. That's a stem and a trunk. Well, we're going to look. I want people to finish that. The other one is the activity book.
What page?
Hold on. Okay, next one is activity book. And it's page.
Huh? What?
34. Looks like that, okay? Well, my camera isn't very clear. All right. Everybody finished with this one?
Teacher, I finished.
Okay. All right, let's go back to the activity book. All right, let's go look back at this activity book page. All right, so on here, it says in small groups, go into the school compound. School compound, that means yard. And collect, well. Oh, that's page 34. Sorry, I cut it off.
Yeah, it's finished.
All right. Well, hold on. I'll put the page up here.
Finish.
Well, I don't know how you finish.
All right. I am finished.
All right.
Sure.
So instead of going to the school, all right, so we're going to draw two leaves here. All right, and you write one word to describe each leaf. So let's have a look at some of the pictures from our school. All right, so everybody wait there. Keep your book open. Keep your book open.
Okay.
And let's have a look at some of these pictures we talked about before. Okay, here we go. This is our non-living and living things at the school. So do you remember we labeled everything? Right? Living things were trees and grass and plants and a garden. Non-living were things that people made. All right.
Basketball.
Yeah, basketball, net, grass, cars, leaves. So let's have a look. That's the same picture. Now let's have a look over here. Now we're going to look at some of these things, these plants, and we're going to draw one. So let's use this plant. We're going to draw this leaf.
Leaf.
Right? Or this
banana leaf.
It is a banana leaf. So let's see if I can get a better picture of it. I don't think so. Oh, that's a better one over there, but let's do this one.
That is cool.
Yeah, so let me get closer. There we go.
Wow.
Look, you're going to try and draw this leaf. Or this one, right? So on leaf number one, everybody does the banana leaf. Let me get a piece of paper.
Banana.
Get a piece. There it is.
Banana leaf.
That is a banana
leaf. Where are you going?
I just had to get a paper. All right, so everybody in box number
one. Need paper.
I have paper because I can't draw on the
book. Need paper. Okay, run, get some paper.
Okay. But you can put it in your book, okay? Activity 24, page 34. And you're in leaf number one, draw a banana leaf. All right? So I'm going to put a little box in here. And I'll show you what I get. And I'm going to write the word leaf. One. All right. Now I got to keep the picture up. I can't draw on the computer because you need the picture. So draw a banana leaf. Try and copy this. There's some here.
Okay. Draw a banana leaf.
There's some here. There's some here. There's some here. And I think these are banana leaves too. So pick one and try your best to draw it.
No, draw one banana leaf.
Just one, okay? So draw it the best you can. All right? And do I have my color? Where's my colors? There they are.
Hello.
Colors. Banana leaves are they small or big? It's the garden of the earth, and the leaf hangs over it. It looks like at the top comes a little round point at the top. Let's add some color. Darker light green. All right, so do your best.
Picture.
All right, let's see if I can finish. All right, good. Let me get mine finished. I'm looking for. Picture. Yep. I'm looking for a nice green. I have a very. Let's have a look. Hold on. Sorry, I've got this one up. Here we go. Nice. What do you got?
Leaf. Leaf.
Nice. Hey, that's a good leaf.
Yeah.
Nice leaf nut.
Thank you.
Nice leaf. Very nice leaf. All right, let's see if I don't have green. Got every color but green. Why? I don't know. All right, I got a very dark green, so I guess I use.
She got a.
I had a light green.
Circle leaf.
Yeah, well, it's kind of a. I don't know what the shape that is. It's more like a.
Circle leaf.
Well, that one's. The banana leaf's not really a circle.
Banana? It's not a circle.
No. And you need a word to describe a banana leaf. What one word would you choose to describe a banana leaf? If you look at that leaf in the picture, what would you say? What are some words to describe it? That means words that tell something about it. Like if I would pick a color, I would say green. All right? If I would pick like a texture, I might say smooth. If I'm going to pick size, I would pick like big, huge, very big. So you use the word, I'm going to use the word big because where I come from, we don't have banana trees. We have nothing like that. So for me, that is one big, big.
Picture.
So my one word to describe it, I'm going to put.
Picture. No, please.
Let's have a look. Nice. Oh, those are nice, not? Nice. Right, you need a word to describe. So here's mine. So that's the leaf I drew. And I put the word big. Where did I put the word big? There it is. I put the word big in there, okay? So in leaf number one, that's what I drew. Okay, I'll probably label it.
Mm-hmm.
I'll probably label it banana leaf. All right, so that's what you need to do with your labeling. So I put banana leaf and I put big. I have one word to describe it only, and I picked big. I could also say beautiful. I could also say, I guess that's it. Big, beautiful, green, smooth. What else I say? Those are good words for it. Yeah, I know, a catchy song, huh? All right, I think we have time to do one more, but I want everybody to do one banana leaf.
Picture.
Wow, Nut, you're doing a great job on your, look at that. You should become a plant expert.
Mippin. Leaf or mippin.
Well, I don't know, you draw a lot of really nice plants and leaves. I have a friend of mine who did that. Now he draws plants and books. He was so good at it. Oh, I don't have another green. I thought I had two greens in here. Aha! There it is. Two greens. All right. How's everybody doing with the banana leaf? Is it all drawn? Can I get rid of that one? All right. If you drew it, make sure you label it.
Okay. I have five greens.
Five?
Greens.
Okay. I only have two. Okay. I wanted to use this one because it's so much lighter. All right, so good. Let's draw another leaf. So I'm going to go back to my pictures. And let's see what other kind of leaf I can draw. Maybe here. Let's go to another picture. I'm going to try to find a leaf.
Picture.
No, that's not very good. Let's go back.
Picture.
Let's. Oh, I see a good leaf. Let's zoom in on a leaf. There we go. Let's go to 200. Make it a little closer. Woohoo! Look at all these leaves.
Picture.
Yeah.
Leaf for.
You what?
A leaf for papaya.
Okay. Oh, that would be a good one too. All right. So let's pick a leaf for. Oh, that looks like a nice leaf. Trying to find one we can draw that's easy. Yeah. That's a banana leaf again. So we're not going to draw that. Let's see if this tree has any nice leaves. Let's have a look. Ah, here we go. How about this one? Let's try and draw that leaf. All right. That one looks like a pretty good. There's two of them. All right. Looks like we can see one. So that is leaf two. So this is leaf two. All right. Let's see what we got. Let's see if I can draw that. Okay. So. Kind of has a stem or a little branch.
T-shirt.
Yeah. Oops, that's more sharp. That's not bad at all. Let's have a look. Hold on. I'm looking at the picture. How'd you do? Nice. Nut, you're doing a great job. All right. How are you doing, Preem? Are you good? You doing some drawing? All right. So try and draw this leaf here. That's a good one. Good view. And I need a word to describe it.
Oh, picture. Oh, I'm doing color.
I'm going to add some color. But now I need a word to describe this. Well, color is only green since we're doing
it. For leaf two, what do you want to drawing?
This one. Do this leaf here.
Okay.
All right. It's probably one of the better ones on the picture. So we drew a banana leaf. I don't know what kind of tree this is, but that's a good picture of a leaf. All right, so draw it the best you can, and I'll show you mine. And I need a word to describe it. All right, the book says name one word to describe it. So I don't know, what am I going to call that? Beautiful. I'll just put the word green.
Yeah, sure.
All right. So draw. Oh, let's see if I can do this in another color. I think I can. So draw this, these leaves here. Something in
there.
Yeah. Yep. How'd you do? How you doing? Is that Nut again? Hi, Nut. Oh, you're just drawing lots of leaves. All right. So draw the yellow ones, the one I circled in yellow. And I'll show you mine because I'm almost finished.
Teacher, draw the flower too, or no?
Well, we're just doing leaves. Part of this is leaf one and leaf two. So don't need to do the fruit. It wants the leaves.
Okay.
All right. So you don't have to draw too much, just the leaf.
Okay. Let's
make this a little better. Gonna make this stand out somehow. There we go. And I just called it green. All right, it's kind of a not a great description word, because all leaves are green. Beautiful. All right, so here is my picture that I drew. All right, right there. So that is the leaf I drew. I put green. That's a little better. Now it can be in focus. That's leaf two, and this was leaf one. All right, so on leaf one and leaf two, and we'll stop after leaf two. All right, and then we'll do two more next week.
Okay.
Okay, so that's good. I think we'll be finished time soon. Yeah, we'll do page 35 later, and I'll find some more pictures of leaves.
Okay.
So the yellow one I circled in yellow, just draw one of those. All right, and I've got mine done, so.
Hey, sure.
Yep.
No.
None, you're drawing like mad. I like it. That looks like a fir tree of some type.
Ah.
Uh-oh. Yeah.
Picture the diamond leaf. Diamond.
Yeah, it does. Oh, that's a good one. I wonder what the shape that is.
Diamond.
Could be a diamond or an oval. That's a good word to describe it. Very good word. Maybe I'll search
that. Yes, oval.
Yeah, kind of an oval, kind of a diamond too. Maybe I'll use that word. Thank you, Nut. I think I'm going to use your. Did Nut give me that? Yeah. I think I'm going to put oval instead of green. Because all leaves are green, except in the fall. There we go. Thank you. That was a good description word. All right, so there's mine. There's my other leaf, and I put the word oval. All right, and there's my other one. And I put big for the banana leaf. All right, so everybody should have two leaves drawn. Okay, and I will scan this and put it up next week. Some pencils. Everybody's doing good. Now, while you're finishing, I'm going to show you a quick little video. Who's seen the movie WALL-E? WALL-E! Have you guys seen that movie?
What is WALL-E?
WALL-E is a movie that a lot of kids your age watch because there's very little words. It's mostly just watching. So in this part, the earth is kind of really dirty and everybody has left. Okay, it's like a big garbage dump, and WALL-E finds a plant. So let me show you this little clip from WALL-E. All right, it's a really fun movie. I would say try and watch it. It's not really scary. Where's WALL-E? So this is WALL-E. All right, so let's get this bigger. So at this point, all the humans left the earth because it got too dirty. All right. And all was left was WALL-E, who kept trying to clean it up. So here we go.
I know WALL-E is.
Oh. It might have a different name here in Thailand. Okay, so that's from a movie called WALL-E. All right. And that's a time when all the humans left Earth because it was too dirty to live on. And WALL-E found a plant, which means Earth was getting better. All right. Okay, so good job. So leave this one, finish off this one, and we'll save that for tomorrow. Good job, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Wait, now we got our goodbyes.
Goodbye.